I'm Dr. Kelli Wilson, and I'm the Director of Compound Management at NCATS, National Center for Advancing Translational Science. Our mission is to support all NCATS researchers for any needs they have related to compounds, and that includes storage, registration, shipping, and reformatting of those compounds. We do a lot of liquid handling. We have lots of different liquid handling instruments. Some of those are physical liquid handlers, so movement of compounds from, say, a tube into a plate. We also have acoustic liquid handlers as well. Those all move compounds in liquid using a sound wave. Everyone in my group has expertise in storage material and storage conditions for different compounds. There are some compounds that are light sensitive. There are other compounds that cannot be dissolved in certain solvents, and those are all important to know when storing those compounds. They also have expertise in compound structures, so looking at different chemical structures and understanding what are the differences between those compounds. Most people start off with our technology after they've done that sort of experimental design, and then their interaction with my group begins when they say, okay, now I want to put some compounds into this experiment. I want to see what different compounds do. I get questions all the time of, let's say that the experiment I'm doing is for infectious disease. What is the best collection of compounds that I can test against these? We can assist you with that so that the compounds you're putting into this experiment are really the most optimal to get you the answer that you need. Our compound management group can actually plate combinations of compounds. So not just testing one compound at a time, testing multiple compounds to see, do these work better together than they do separately. One of the projects we had really not that long ago was a malaria project. So malaria is already treated with a three-drug combination, but resistance appears just like with most other infectious diseases. And so there was one NCATS researcher who was able to work with compound management to actually plate three-drug combinations against resistant strains to see if any of those three-drug combinations could potentially sensitize and kill those malaria strains. There's lots of clinical situations that involve multiple drugs, and the fact that we're able to actually test that here is really great. Maybe we could find something that could actually be translated to a clinical trial or to helping a patient population somewhere.